Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family of the C.K. McClatchy High School VAPA Music Program. My name is Jorge Muñoz. I'm the program's director. The musicians and I are delighted that you've joined us, and we're excited to present our fall concert entitled Music for Our Time. The fact that you are experiencing this concert through your electronic devices says a lot about the times we are living in. It is difficult to find normalcy these days. Tonight's program will not shy away from the challenges of our time, but will also not dwell on them. As is often the case with music and the arts, we are here not to present the obvious. Our intention is to engage the mind, open the heart, and elevate the spirit. We hope that in a way, this concert will help remind you of how things can be and how they will be once again. The program opened with a full orchestra's performance of Engines of Resistance by Larry Clark. In it, you may have noticed the struggle between two distinct musical ideas. In the end, neither prevails independently. Instead, both ideas prevail simultaneously when each adopts aspects of the other. We are left to wonder if the composer hid a lesson in the music. Next, the band presents the piece America Verses by Timothy Broge. This piece is a set of variations or verses on the song America or My Country Tis of Thee. As you will hear, the piece is not conventionally celebratory. The composer describes his intent as follows. The history of America is complex, to say the least, and the joys and sorrows of American life are equally complex. There has been much to celebrate, much to lament, much to be proud of, much to regret. Some of this ambivalence finds its way into America Verses. If the composer loves his country, which he does, that love is conditioned by an awareness of how much remains to be done before America is transformed into an enlightened, creative, and just society. It is for the listener to determine the message of the work, to decide whether the music ends on a note of despair or in a mood of hushed optimism.
Thank you. Hello, Michael Frost here, coach of the viola section at McClatchy High School. Happy to share some stirring string sounds next from Beethoven, especially as it's a big birthday celebration year for him. He'll be turning 250 this December. Imagine all the birthday candles on that cake. Well, it was during the early 1800s that Beethoven, still young in his 30s, but facing failing hearing, he composed his revolutionary Third Symphony, dedicating it to a military leader that he passionately believed in, Napoleon Bonaparte. Now, Bonaparte championed Beethoven's shared values of liberation and was fighting against Europe's repressive royal rulers in the name of democracy for all. But when Beethoven found out that Bonaparte had crowned himself emperor, and Beethoven just lost his top in rage. He blew his top, ripping through the original dedication on the score, declaring Bonaparte a tyrant after all, writing in a new dedication, Eroica, the hero, Beethoven, he added, to the memory of a great man, to the memory of a great man in disappointment. Well, I say happy birthday, Beethoven. And even after 200 years, thank you for all that music and for reminding us still today, during our own turbulent social and political times, to stand up for what you believe in with passion, but just do it with a cooler head than Beethoven. So now let's enjoy these themes on Symphony No. 3, the Eroica, by Beethoven. Here's a performance by the McClatchy High School String Orchestra.
My name is Bessa Miller, and I am a vocalist in the chamber choir. During uncertain times like the ones we are living through right now, we all need to find something stable to support us. For many, the stability comes from their faith, spirituality, or religion. From the beginning of recorded history, humans have used music to form a connection to the divine. The song Down in the River to Pray is an example of this. The origins of the song are unknown, with its roots firmly planted in the Christian folk hymn, African American spiritual, Appalachian song, and Southern gospel traditions. Regardless of its background and its variations, the song's plea to a higher power for guidance carries a message of longing for a better time and place.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
Hi, my name is Keikoa Bright, and I play piano and keyboard at the McClatchy High School VAPA music program. Just as some people rely on their faith to help sustain them through tough times, others fall back on the support of fellow human beings, whether that relationship could be through a family member, a friend, or your community. Having the encouragement of these communities is essential during times like these. Our current political environment has created bubbles of like-minded individuals, and these bubbles fall short of giving us a balanced worldview. However, they do provide a space where feelings and views can be safely shared. In our area, these pockets do lean a little bit more progressively. And in the spirit of this progressive inclination of the West Coast, the CKM Jazz Ensemble presents to you Prog Pacific. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ginger Rubin, and I play cello in the orchestra. Composer Yukiko Nishimura wrote the piece Water Reflections to illustrate the contrast between objects and the reflections in water. The reflections appear distorted when the surface of the water is agitated and well-defined when the surface of the water is calm. The intent of this music itself can be interpreted as a reflection of our own experiences. In these turbulent times, it is important to remember that our thoughts and feelings are clearer and our actions more constructive when our minds are calm.
Hello everyone, my name is Lily Ross and I'm a vocalist in the Women's Chamber Choir. Whether you rely on your faith, your community, or your inner strength to see you through difficult times, it is important to remember that things will improve. Country music legend Dolly Parton expressed this sentiment in her song, Light of a Clear Blue Morning. In it, she describes difficult times as a long dark night and the optimistic outlook needed for better times as a brand new day dawning. The song begins with the following lyrics. It's been a long dark night and I've been waiting for the morning. It's been a long hard fight, but I can see a brand new day dawning. I've been looking for the sunshine, you know I ain't seen it in so long. But everything's gonna work out just fine, and everything's gonna be all right that's been all wrong.
That's been all wrong.
Hello, my name is Catherine Tatro. I play cello in the orchestra and guitar in the jazz ensemble. It is imperative that we not forget to recognize and celebrate the wonderful things that life has to offer, especially in times like these. Bond with your loved ones, take pleasure in that which brings you joy, and make time for yourself. We hope that this next jazzy blues shuffle tune helps transfer you to a happier time and place. The Jazz Ensemble presents Jamie Abersold's Hustle and Shuffle.
Before our final piece, the musicians and I would like to thank our many supporters, Principal Egan and the entire McClatchy administrative team for their guidance, VAPA program team leader Molly Morrison and the entire VAPA team for their encouragement and friendship, our program's talented music coaches for their unwavering dedication to our students and their commitment to our mission of providing a substantial music education for all who seek it. Aaron Hines and Spencer Hannibal Smith from our virtual ensemble who created this video presentation. And of course, we'd like to thank you for joining us. At this time, I'd like to appeal to your charity and ask you to consider making a financial contribution to our worthy organization. Needless to say, the restrictions imposed by the pandemic have hampered our fundraising endeavors. If you are in a position to support us financially, look for the information concerning contributions and donations in the program's closing credits. We close our concert with a setting of the American folk song, We Shall Overcome. The song's message of brotherhood and perseverance has helped unify people during times of struggle. As such, we hope you agree that it is a fitting ending to our program. Ladies and gentlemen, Overcome, performed by the musicians of the C.K. McClatchy VAPA Music Program.